Hey students, welcome back to my channel Bansal Biology. In today's video, we are going to learn about a very important topic, that is secondary structure of proteins and Ramachandran plot part 2. As it is a part 2 video, there is a part 1 video that already I have uploaded in my YouTube channel, and it is a very important video also. So before going with this video, I would request you to watch that video so that your concepts are crystal clear and you will be able to remember this topic and learn this topic very easily. This is also a rank booster topic and many questions are asked from this topic. So let's get started with the video and learn this video. So the first thing that we'll just recall about is primary structure. If you remember that when the amino acids are joined together by the peptide bond, they form a linear structure. What they will form? They will form a linear structure, and this linear structure will be known as primary structure. So in this, the primary structure contains peptide bond. Now there will be a modification in this primary structure that will result into the formation of secondary structure. So now what will happen is that the primary structure will start coiling. This was the primary structure. What will it will do? So these kind of coiling structures is known as secondary structure, that the primary structure has converted into the secondary structure by coiling. So this secondary structure is of two type. It can be left-handed or it can be right-handed. For more clarity, just imagine.
What we can do, we can use a pen and we can use any thread that we can consider it as a protein structure, the linear protein structure. Now what will happen, this linear protein structure will coil around this pen. Okay, so if it is coiling around in clockwise direction, if it is coiling around clockwise direction, then it will be known as right-handed helix. And if it is rotating around in left-handed, or we can say in anti-clockwise direction, then it will be known as what? Left-handed helix. So if it is rotating in clockwise direction, just simple concept, if rotating around in clockwise direction, then right-handed. And if it is rotating around anti-clockwise, then it is left-handed helix.
So, or you can understand it by using your thumbs. For example, if this is the right hand and the coiling will occur in this way. So if the coiling is occurring in this way and you are using your right hand, then it is right-handed helix. And if there is left hand and the coiling is occurring in this way, then it is what? This is left-handed helix. Generally in nature, the more amount of the helix that is present is of right-handed. Right-handed secondary structures are present generally in nature as compared to left-handed. Why is it so? Because this left-handed helix show more steric hindrance. It shows more steric hindrance. So more amount of right-handed helix of secondary structure is present as compared to left-handed structure. If we see which bond is present in the secondary structure, then the most important is hydrogen bond. Due to the hydrogen bonding, the secondary structure is formed. What happened is, when you convert a linear structure in a helical form, then what will happen? The amino acids that were far in the linear structure will come close to each other. And when they come to close to each other, what will they do? They will form a hydrogen bond. Now the hydrogen bond will be formed between the H of amino group, the hydrogen of amino group, and the oxygen of carboxylic group. And the oxygen of carboxylic group. So between these two, the hydrogen bond will be formed. So it is formed between the hydrogen and oxygen. But the hydrogen and oxygen will be formed between the N and N plus 4 amino acid. What is that? For example, there is one amino acid. This is N. After that, there will be N plus 1. After that, there will be N plus 2. After that, N plus 3. And after that, N plus 4. So the O of this and the H of this will form a hydrogen bond. Why is it so? Because these two are close to each other so that they can form a hydrogen bond. For example, you can see in picture also that here, this oxygen and this hydrogen is forming a
hydrogen bond. So this is a N amino acid and this is a N plus 4 amino acid. So these two will form a hydrogen bond. Very important point, that which of the amino acids formed a hydrogen bond in secondary structure, that is first amino acid and the successive fourth amino acid. So due to this, the stabilizing of the secondary structure occurs. Okay, so just remember this, the hydrogen of N and the oxygen of carboxylic group. In this, if you can see in the picture, there are, one second, just let me erase this. In this picture, you can see there are turns present. Okay, so these turns form a unit. One turn will form one unit and then the second turn will form the another unit. So these are known as repeated unit in the secondary structure. Each repeated unit is of 5.4 angstrom. The length of each repeating unit is 5.4 angstrom in helical structure, in alpha helix structure. It is what? It is alpha helix structure. Very important, what is the length of the each unit in a secondary structure is 5.4 angstrom. And at each turn, there are 3.6 residues, 3.6 amino acid. Now, how they are formed? Let's see. For example, once again, 1, N plus 1, N plus 2, N plus 3 and N plus 4. So, these three amino acid will totally present. And the 1/3 of this amino acid and the 1/3 of this amino acid will be present in the turn. So the 1/3 of this amino acid will contain the NH group and the 1/3 of this amino acid will contain the oxygen group. And this part will form one turn. This part will form one turn. So 1, 2, 3, 3 amino acid plus 0.33 of this and plus 0.33 of this will form 3.6 residues in per turn. So according to this, there is 3.66 amino acid in one turn instead of 4. Okay, instead of 4 or 5. One more very important point, if you remember about the psi bond and the phi bond. The psi bond was between alpha C alpha carbon and the carboxylic group carbon, and the psi bond was between C alpha carbon and the amino group. So in this, if you want a stable helical structure, because we know that if the amino acids come too close to each other, or any side chain or any group if come close to each other, then what will they cause? They will cause steric hindrance, and due to which the secondary structure won't be stable. So if we want to form a stable secondary structure, what we need is that the C alpha and the C bond must range from minus 45 degree to minus 55 at the angle of minus 45 to minus 55. While C alpha and the N angle rotation must be of minus 60. At this rotation, what can happen? The secondary structure will be stable. So what is negative in this? Negative is anticlockwise, and 45 and 50 is showing the angle of rotation. So if it was at zero angle, then it has shown some rotation anticlockwise and it is now at 45 and 55 degree angle. You will understand it very properly if you watch the previous video. Okay, so these two is very important, that at what angle the secondary structure alpha helix is stable. So in the case of psi, it is stable at minus 45 and minus 55, minus 45 to minus 55, and the phi is stable at minus 60. Let's move further. There are some of the amino acids that affect the stability of secondary structure alpha helix. So in alpha helix, the stability can be affected by the glutamate amino acid. If many glutamate amino acid are present together, like many a number of amino acid of glutamate are present together, so what will happen? In this, there is a side chain that is negative. So what happened? This negative side chain will repel each other, and due to this repulsion, what will happen? The secondary structure won't remain stable. So what will happen? Repulsion will occur between the negative
साइड चेन. सो इफ ग्लूटामेट इज प्रेजेंट इन मेनी नंबर. सिमिलरली इफ वी टेक द कंसिडरेशन ऑफ पॉजिटिवली चार्ज अमाइनो एसिड लाइक लाइसिन आर्जिनिन. So if they are present together in many numbers, so what will happen? Positively charged side chains are present in many number. So once again they will repel each other, because positive charge or negative charge will repel each other. Only opposite charge will attract each other. So in this case also what will happen? Repulsion will occur and the secondary structure will not remain stable. And some of the bulkier amino acid can also cause the instability of the secondary structure. For example, asparagine, serine, threonine. If these kind of amino acids are present together in very number, so what can happen? They can cause the instability of the secondary structure, that is alpha helix. Till now we have what discussed? We have discussed about the alpha helix only. Plus there are two amino acids that are restricted in the formation of alpha helical structure. They are restricted during the formation of, or we can say constrained in the formation of alpha helix structure. Those two amino acids are, first is proline and second is glycine. Why is it so? Because here you can see the C alpha and the N are bound in the bond between these two are bound in a ring. They are present in a ring. So due to which this bond cannot rotate very well. Due to which what will happen, it won't be able to form that minus 60 angle. So that will form an instability in the secondary structure. So first reason is that it can't rotate, which bond, the phi bond, cannot show rotation. Plus this ring is very rigid and it is bulkier. So due to that also it cannot be used for the formation of secondary structure. So due to which this proline is not used in the alpha helical structure. And about the glycine is very flexible. Why? Because it only contains a H bond. So in this, the H group is present in the glycine. And due to which it is very less bulkier and it has more flexibility. Due to which what will happen? It can rotate at higher degree as compared to another amino acid. If it will rotate at higher degree, it won't be forming a similar conformation as that of rest of the amino acid. That will result also into the instability of the secondary structure. So these two amino acids, that is proline and glycine, are restricted in the formation of alpha helical structure. Very important point. The questions are asked regarding these two. So it is a very important, and which two amino acids are restricted? Proline and glycine. Glycine because due to its high flexibility, and proline is due to its low flexibility and less rotation and rigid ring. Okay, so this was about the alpha helical structure. Now let's see about the beta sheet structure. It is a second type of secondary structure. In beta sheet, what will happen? There is nothing like that of coiling and all. Here, what is happening? Here, the amino acids are present in a zigzag manner. Okay, so here you can see there is a zigzag manner of pattern. In this also, like that of alpha helix, the R group will be protruding outside. That they will be outside. They will be not present in the backbone, but they will be present outside. But in this, a special condition is occurring that the adjacent amino acid are present opposite to each other. Like this is present here, so its adjacent one is present above. Then this is present below, then the adjacent one is present above. So like that condition is occurring here, that is not shown in the alpha helical structure. In beta sheets also, there will be the presence of hydrogen bond that will stabilize the secondary structure and that will form the secondary structure of beta sheet. But in this, what is happening? In this, the polypeptides are present adjacent to each other. Not like before that the polypeptide is coiling around each other. But in this, the polypeptides are present adjacent to each other. And what is happening that the edge of this will form a bond with oxygen of this. So like this bond will be formed, not like before that here is oxygen and here is hydrogen and the bond is formed. Here not like that is there. In this, the two different chains are there that will form a hydrogen bond. This beta sheets can be of two type. It can be parallel beta sheets or it can be anti-parallel beta sheet. As the name is suggesting, parallel. Parallel, that is that both the chain will run in one direction. It is running from N to C and N group to the C group. Then it will also run from amino group to the carboxylic group. But in anti-parallel, what is happening? If one is running from N to C, then the another will be running from C to N. Okay, if one is running from amino group to the carboxylic group, the another will run from carboxylic group to amino group. So there is a little bit difference you can see in the hydrogen bond. These blue are hydrogen bond. So it is anti-parallel. And this here are hydrogen bond in parallel. So there is just a bit of the difference, not much. But yes, there is a difference in each repeating unit. Likewise, we have seen in the alpha helix, there were repeating units were present. In this also, repeating units are present. So in this, one repeating unit is 7 angstrom long in anti-parallel. And in parallel, it is 6.5 angstrom long. Very important, in alpha helix, it was 5.4 angstrom. In anti-parallel, it is 7.4. And in parallel, it is 6.5 angstrom. Very important point. I'm telling you guys, this point is very important. Okay. So this is what this is, beta sheet. Now let's move further to beta turns. If there is a polypeptide chain, what will happen? The polypeptide chain shows sharp turns. They will show sharp turns. The protein shows very sharp turns. So these sharp turns are known as beta turns. Turns, as the name is suggesting, that turn. You take a turn of car also. If there is a sharp road, you take a turn. So that is what beta turn. So it is what? It is any sharp turn that occurs in a protein. So in this turn, there are total 4 amino acids that are included. Always remember that in beta turns, there are 4 amino acids are included, and between the first and fourth amino acid, there is a hydrogen bond present. So here you can see that the oxygen of the first amino acid and the hydrogen of fourth amino acid is forming a hydrogen bond that will stabilizes this turn. Now, no hydrogen bond will be formed between the second amino acid or the third amino acid. Just between the first and fourth, there will be a hydrogen bond. Very important point that in beta turn, how many amino acids are involved? 4 amino acids. And the hydrogen bond is formed between first amino acid and fourth amino acid. And this, in this beta turn, proline and glycines are present in high amount. It is just opposite what we have learnt in alpha helix. In this, proline and glycine are present in higher amount. Proline and glycine are present in higher amount. What is the reason behind that? Is that proline can show turn. Proline can easily turn. Here you can see this is the ring. This ring is helping in turning. So this proline helps in turning. And the glycine is flexible. Glycine is very much flexible. So it can be also used in rotating. So these two, proline and glycine, two amino acids are present in higher amount in beta turns. That are proline and glycine. Total 4 amino acids are involved. And first and fourth amino acid will show a hydrogen bond. According to these, there was a plot made by Ramachandran. Here you can see this Ramachandran plot is very similar to the plot that we have learned in the previous video regarding the amino acid. So here in this point, at this point, there will be a left alpha helix.
At this point, there will be what will present? Left alpha helix will be present and it will be found very stably at this location. At this point, at the top, at this point, what will present? At that point, right alpha helix will be present. Okay, at this point, there will be anti-parallel beta sheet will be present. And at this point, there will be parallel beta sheet will be present at stable point. But you have to remember these a little bit like that. You have to remember that anti-parallel will occur when psi is at positive and phi is at negative. Similarly, parallel will occur when psi is positive but phi is negative. Left will occur when both are positive. Right alpha helix will occur when both are negative. Okay, these all are for L amino acids. Okay, L amino acids, we have seen that amino acids can occur in two chiral forms, that is left and right. So these Ramachandran plot is for left amino acid. Very important point, very very important point, that this is for L amino acid, and you must remember a bit that they are at positive or they are at negative and somewhat of the angle, like this is present nearly around 130. It is present nearly around 120. So you must know about these angles for the exam point of view. For the D chiral, you just have to change a position little bit. Here, this is for L chiral. So here, beta sheet was present in this column. So here, you have to shift it here for the D chirals. And here, the right-handed alpha helix were present here, right? You can see here, the right-handed alpha helix were present. You have to shift it here in the upper column, and the left-handed you have to shift here. You don't have to do very much of the work, you just have to shift. So there the positive positive here will be negative negative, there the negative negative here will be the positive positive. So here the left-handed alpha helix will be negative negative at negative negative angles, the right-handed will be at positive positive angles, and it will be at positive and negative, but positive of phi and negative of psi. Here it was positive of psi and negative of phi. So just that change you have to remember in your mind. That's it about the Ramachandra plot. Just these things you have to remember. That this is the just simple thing. These Ramachandra plot is what is telling that the angle rotation, that how much rotation can these amino acids show so that these helical structures will be stable. So guys, this was all about my today's video. I hope this video will help you a lot regarding the questions of Ramachandra plot, secondary structures. All the questions will be covered in this video. So watch this video very properly. You will be able to solve the questions very easily. We'll discuss the previous year questions in the next video. So thank you so much guys for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and share this video with all your friends. Thank you so much guys. Bye.